Title: Arrived in the United States. Chapter 510 to 511. The phone call was not connected, as if Yvette had no time. Chuck was worried. Was Yvette blocked by another killer? Chuck continued to call, but fortunately, it was connected the second time. Hello husband, I will be the, wait for me. Chuck was relieved. Sister Betty, let's go to the airport. Chuck said. Well, Master, let's go downstairs. The car is ready. Betty took Chuck downstairs. Drive and go to the airport. Private jets have been prepared for a long time, and it is not possible to go to the United States in an hour or two. At the airport, the two went in and waited. Chuck is worried. Yvette has been in danger for how many days? Chuck can only hope that Yvette can reach the airport safely. Time passed by 1 minute and 1 second, and it was almost time. Betty asked, Master, do you want me to pick up Yvette now? The killing order of the killer organization is not a joke. After all, Yvette's strength is not too strong. Being able to stand alone for a few days shows that Yvette's strength has been greatly improved. Chuck was anxious like the ants on the hot pot. He called Yvette and Betty breathed a sigh of relief. Master, Yvette is here, over there. Chuck looked over and saw a woman with a peaked cap approaching. Chuck ran over and hugged Yvette. My dear husband, wait, it hurts. Yvette's lips were pale. She had been besieged 3 times in the past 3 days. Each time she almost died. Fortunately, Yvette resisted and tried to make herself alive. Chuck felt distressed. How much did she suffer in the past 3 days? When we arrive in the US, we must ask my mother to help Yvette solve this matter. Chuck hurriedly released her. Wife, get on the plane. Yes. Yvette was haggard. She was so tired, and now she could finally rest after suffering for a long time. Sister Betty, get on the plane, Chuck said. Betty opened the way. Chuck and Yvette got on the plane. Chuck found Yvette's condition is very bad. He wanted to check out Yvette's injury. Yvette shook her head and refused. No, I'm ugly, don't look. Yvette knew that she was blue and purple, and she even had a gunshot wound. As a woman, of course, she hoped that Chuck would see her perfect self. But I haven't seen it. Chuck felt distressed. No husband, I just wanted to sleep, Yvette said with a hint of prayer in her voice. Chuck persisted this way. Yvette didn't know how to refuse. Master, I'm going to help Yvette take a good look, Betty said. Yvette sighed. Betty is also a woman, this is no problem. Wife, then I'm out, Chuck said. Chuck went out and found a place to sit down. The plane had already begun to fly over to the United States. Betty checked Yvette's body and said, the clothes have been taken off, and you hurt a lot. Yeah, Yvette is actually not very embarrassed. After all, they are both women, although Yvette's beautiful body was only seen by Chuck. Betty saw that Yvette was wounded, but the beauty of the woman could not be covered by the scars. Betty is professional and started to treat Yvette's wounds. You and Master, did you do the husband and wife? Betty asked Yvette. If you have a baby, then. No, no. Yvette shook her head busy. It's been a long time with Chuck. If Yvette didn't know that Karen Lee killed her father, she would give it. Maybe she is pregnant now. Yvette knew what Karen Lee did. But she was able to be with Chuck now. She was particularly guilty in her heart. She was ashamed of her father. The final bottom line, she could not cross this threshold. Then the Master Chuck didn't mention it? He mentioned it, but I don't want to do it. I can't cross that hurdle. Yvette didn't hide from Betty. She knew that it was useless to hide. She was nothing to hide from Karen Lee. Between herself and Karen Lee, she didn't do anything to herself. Then one day she felt that she could challenge Karen Lee and just tell Karen Lee. Karen Lee meets with herself, it's that simple. You don't have to turn around, let alone worry about Karen Lee avoiding herself. Well, I personally advise you. The matter between you and President Karen Lee is not resolved. Don't break through the last step, because of what? How to tell you this, it's not that I underestimate you, You will not be President Karen Lee's opponent in another 10 years, so you can try to accept. Betty persuaded. No, I will never accept it. Yvette's eyes were cold, she put on her own clothes, thank you. This. Anyway, don't make the young master sad. If you and the young master have children, then Karen Lee will never appear. I know that if you let her wait for me, I will surpass her one day. Yvette said. Ugh. Betty sighed, you have a good rest. If it is not the young master who really likes you, I will not do it for you. I know, thank you. Yvette sincerely thanked that she knew that Karen Lee gave herself a chance to grow at Will because of Chuck. After all, to put it simply, Karen Lee is now too easy to kill herself, Yvette knows, but this cannot pass. That's her own father. Betty came out and gave Yvette a good rest. Chuck has been waiting, Sister Betty, how is she doing? Master, rest assured, just rest. Well, Chuck wanted to go in with her, but Chuck didn't go in when he thought that it would disturb her. Betty began to introduce some of the power of the Rice Country. Especially for this killer organization, after the killing order has been issued, it has not been recovered. Betty does not know whether Karen Lee can solve this killing order. Everything can only be known after arriving in the United States. Chuck heard this, he only had to worry about it, and it was difficult for his mother to solve it. So how strong was the background of this killer organization? And in Chief Lee's family. Betty couldn't speak anymore, Chuck didn't know yet, Karen Lee was kicked out of the house by Lee's family. What's wrong with my mother? For this matter, Miss Karen Lee will definitely tell it to you, Betty couldn't say it. Master, you have a good night's sleep, and you will come to the United States when you sleep. Well, Chuck lay down and went to sleep. He was indeed tired. Betty walked to the front and called Karen Lee. The call was connected. President Karen Lee, Master and Yvette is already on the plane. Leave? Zelda was actually at the airport, but she didn't tell Chuck. She couldn't help it. She wanted to see that she wanted to go to the United States, but Chuck didn't let herself go. She was helpless, Chuck must have something in the past. She sighed and reluctantly went back to deal with her new branch. She didn't know how long Chuck would go to the country this time. But when she turned around, she saw Christine. Yes, reconciled with Chuck, of course Christine wanted to send Chuck, but came over and did not see Chuck. She is also ready to go back. The two women looked at each other, and they smelled of gunpowder. If Zelda didn't know about Chuck and Christine in her office, she wasn't that angry, but she knew that she couldn't help it. And why do you look at me like that? Christine frowned and turned away. She didn't want to quarrel with Zelda. After all, she was a bit nasty, sorry, how to say in her office. Stop. Christine, don't you say you don't like men who are younger than you? Zelda wanted to ask clearly, when did Chuck Band her develop to look like this? Do you want to manage it? Christine was annoyed. This sentence angered her. She insisted on this, but she didn't know why. Maybe the man she likes in her heart will not be affected because of her age. I don't want to control you. But if you trouble me, don't stay in my office when the waves are coming. Zelda was also angry. Christine was said to be blushing. Where did she go? It was forced by Chuck. What's wrong with your office? I still have to be in your house, can you control it? Christine hummed, unwilling to show weakness, scolded by her enemies. She was unhappy. You shameless. Zelda scolded, really angry, actually said such a thing, how could Chuck like her? You are shameless. Zelda, what are you talking about? Christine glared at Zelda. She hates people scolding her the most. I'm not clear enough? Zelda was angry. This Christine actually said that she still had to go to her home? How shameful is this? Zelda, I think you don't want to open some stores, do you? Christine said coldly. But at that time, she bought a street. In this street, Zelda had a store on it. If Chuck hadn't intervened at that time, she had already asked Zelda to move the store away. What do you mean? Zelda frowned slightly. Don't understand yet? You have a storehouse, No, that street is mine. If Chuck didn't speak for you, I would have asked you to move away, said Christine. Zeldo understood her words. Chuck actually helped himself so much? How did he convince Christine? I will move away myself. Zelda made up her mind. She knew which Christine was talking about, and that store had the best business, but the enemy was the landlord, so she continued to open? Zelda didn't whisper so low. You can't move away, Christine said. Why can't I still need to notify you when I move away? I will move back now, Zelda groaned. Where can such a domineering enemy be the host? Where can Zelda stand it? Knowing this, Zelda didn't want to stay for a moment, and moving away would cost a lot of decoration money, but she didn't care. I said, you don't have to leave, and I promised Chuck, Christine said. Do what you promised to do, let Chuck know that she forced Zelda away, it certainly won't work. I have to move. Zelda swayed her long legs and walked outside. Christine chased angrily. The two went to the parking lot. Christine was annoyed. Hey, you move, I let you move. Believe it or not, I will bought all your restaurant and houses. How much can you move? You. Christine, Zelda was angry. This Christine might really be able to do it. This is a female lunatic. Not to mention buying it all, even if only half of it is bought, how much will you lose if you move away? And there is another time to find a place to renovate, which is a great loss. Hum, let you fight with me, and keep on doing it, or I'll stare at you all the time. Christine got into her car. Zelda was angry. I will move away, I will. Don't make me angry, I promised Chuck. Christine was annoyed and started the car. Too lazy to tell you more, if you keep doing it, I will give you rent free. You want me to be exempt? Missing your rent? Zelda asked and wondering why. Continued to do it without lack, I charge you twice. Do you dare to continue to do it? Do you think I dare not? Dare not, you are so timid, and dare to continue to do it? Christine disdain. You, I will show you. Zelda said angrily. You said it yourself, I didn't force you, Christine shrugged. You. Zelda was stunned. Was she actually shocked? Christine saw Zelda's anger, and she suddenly smiled. What are you laughing at? What's so funny? Zelda was particularly angry. No, this is definitely not the case, you still have to move away, otherwise you will collapse. I'm hungry, let's go eat, I haven't eaten together for a long time. Do you say yes? Christine said suddenly. Zelda was stunned. Yes, after the two broke up, not to mention eating, they were too lazy to meet. It was indeed a long time since they had dinner together. It is important to know that when two people are studying in college, they are good friends who don't say anything. It's been a long time since we have eaten together, Zelda suddenly stopped angry. And where to eat? I invite. No, why should you please? Go to my restaurant for dinner. Zelda refused. Also, Christine did not refuse, nodded and agreed. The two looked at each other for a while. Suddenly, both of them laughed. Both of them were originally superb beauties. They smiled slightly, and fell all over the country. Both Zelda and Christine felt that such an adult was still arguing at the same time. How naive! No more noisy. Okay Zelda, let's go to your restaurant, and I haven't eaten what you made in a long time, Christine recalled. When she was in college, Zelda liked to cook. Well, no problem, Zelda smiled. The two are reconciled. If Chuck is here, he will be absolutely surprised. What happens? But after the two of them smiled, they were a bit embarrassed. After all, they both liked Chuck, and they were reconciled without jealousy. Aren't we too? Christine said embarrassedly. Zelda was also awkward. Don't say it, we are reconciled. It has nothing to do with Chuck, Zelda said. Well, you said that we both like him, isn't it? How to divide this? Zelda had a headache, knowing that there was no last step between her and Chuck. Chuck never made guilt, and she didn't think about it particularly. She just thought that if she couldn't marry Chuck, She would have a Chuck child and take care of the child. Then she would have a companion. Or else grow old so lonely. Zelda felt that she would not like others anymore, only Chuck. Don't say this, let's eat. Zelda didn't want this anymore, but she said seriously, Christine. Please don't be in my office with Chuck in the future. Christine blushed and didn't want to, Chuck forced. Otherwise, my office also lent you? Then too clear? Christine thoughtfully. This time it was Zelda's turn blushing, which was a bit irritating. However, Chuck must agree. It is better to agree. Then, with Chuck's permission, you will be pregnant and have a baby. I will not be so lonely afterwards. Don't talk, go eat. Well, the two of us said this was inappropriate. Lara came back by plane and went to the square, but she didn't find Chuck. When asked to Yolanda, Chuck went to United States. She was stupefied and she was holding her mobile phone. This time she came back to meet Chuck. But now Chuck go to the United States, when will he come back? Lara lost her own tea shop, how could this be? She didn't even think about it, and Chuck didn't reply to her WeChat. What should she do? Does Chuck not like her at all? To know that her figure is so good, Chuck should like it, but when she in Logan's place in Beijing she did not lock her door for Chuck to come in, but Chuck did not come at night. Lara sighed sadly. Meanwhile, Master, we are in the country, Betty woke Chuck. Yes, after flying for so long, they finally arrived in the United States. Chuck woke up and found out that Yvette had been sitting next to him long ago, just watching him sleeping. Chuck breathed a sigh of relief, and Yvette looked much better. Chuck held Yvette's hand. Husband, Yvette said. Don't worry, my mother will solve the matter of the killing order. Don't worry when you see my mother. Chuck comforted. He knew that Yvette would not do it in front of himself again, and if she did, Yvette would also tell himself. Yes. Yvette sighed, and she wanted to kill Karen Lee again, and asked her to help, this. Tangled. Yvette was particularly at a loss. After the plane land, Betty took Chuck and Yvette down. Karen Lee was still working on other things in the United States. Let Betty take Chuck to settle down first, and Karen Lee would come over the next few days. Betty knew the headquarters of the killer organization, but Karen Lee didn't come over, she couldn't take Chuck like that. Yvette passed by, what if something happened? After leaving the airport, Chuck couldn't express his emotions. This was his first time abroad. He felt really a little different. The streets are full of beautiful women from different countries. Their body is different from that of Chinese women. There are special bumps. Types of big eyes and high noses. Chuck was thinking, Hannah and Black Rose had already come to the United States, and they had photos of Black Rose in their hands. So is it easy to find her? As long as the photos are sent out, then the Black Rose will definitely come to find him, and then set up to see how she runs.